This tutorial will cover logging in, downloading, and installing your PropulseKit product. This tutorial will apply to all PropulseKit products, and it will also apply to both Mac, Windows, and whichever web browser you're using. There will be minor differences, but this is the general sequence of logging in, downloading, and installing. After you placed your order, you'll have received an email. That email will look something like this, with a subject line of proposal pack, and then your product name, download information. It will give you some information about how many items are on the order. If you ordered multiple packages, you will get multiple download emails. The order number will be at the top. The link to the download page will be near the top. Your login username and password will be underneath the link. And then if you are using our wizard software on Word for Windows, your activation code will be under that here. If you lost your email or you can't find it, first check in your junk mail folder. Some email clients will send our emails to a junk folder. And if this is an old order, say months, weeks, or years ago, your password may have expired, or you may require to upgrade to the newest version. If this is a relatively new order, your login password will be valid. If this is an old order and you need to upgrade or get a new password if you are under an upgrade plan, you can do that by going to our website and clicking the My Orders link. On the My Orders page, you can enter in your order number and your original order email, submit the form, and that will tell you whether you are under an upgrade plan or you can re-download a current version. If all else fails, if you cannot find that, you can use the lost order lookup, put enough information in the form that you may have used in the past order, and if you still cannot find it, click the Contact Us page and send us a note, and we can look it up for you. Back to the email. This link, when you click it, your browser will ask for a user ID and a password. Enter your user ID and password, and you'll be taken to the download page of our website. If you incorrectly type the user ID and password, or if you have an outdated one that has expired, you may see an access denied error message. Make sure you are typing the user ID and password with your keyboard, as if you are using copy and paste with your mouse. That can frequently cause an extra space or line break to be inserted, and that can cause an access denied error. So if you're getting those on a relatively new order and you know your password is correct, it simply means it's not being typed exactly or the copy and paste is not working properly. So type it with the keyboard, that should take care of it. Now once you're on the download page, this download page is the same for Mac, Windows, any platform, and there will be the Windows section up top. If you are a Mac user, you can scroll down to the Mac links. Look at the number at the top of the section. That will tell you how many files you should be downloading and saving to your computer. There are three files for every proposal pack for Windows, because the proposal pack, the title page pack, and then the wizard software are each downloaded and installed separately. For Mac users, the installs are contained in self-uncompressing zip files. When you click these links on Mac, they will automatically download and unzip into a PropulseKit folder within your Mac downloads folder. For Windows, these will download and save as executable installers. Now that we're on the download page, we'll have one or more files to download. Right on the first line under the block that says what platform you're downloading for, in this case Microsoft Windows, says there are three files to download. Under that, you'll see all three download links. You'll see icons with different colors next to each link. Icons with a red background are our proposal packs. A magenta background means it's a title page pack. A purple background will be for legal contract packs. A dark blue background will be for our proposal kit professional bundle. And the green background will be for our wizard software. You'll see different icons depending on what product you ordered. So start at the top, just download each link by clicking it. Your browser will then save to your computer. Depending on the browser, we're using Edge right now, but Chrome, Firefox, Safari, Opera, whatever you're using, will have different ways of showing you the download progress and where your download files are being saved to. If your computer asks you if you want to run or save the download file, always make sure you save it to your computer first. You don't want to run a large installer file directly from the internet. Save the files to your computer first. Okay, now that this one is downloaded, we can run it. Click the next buttons, accept the license agreement. You can change the install folder if you want to change the location from the default. By default, it's going to go to your C drive into a proposal kit folder. And then wait until the installer has copied all of the documents out of the installer onto your hard drive. When the installer is finished, you have the opportunity of viewing the instruction manual, which you can always do at a later time, and also launch the desktop organizer. The desktop organizer opens in your web browser. However, everything is actually on your computer. You can see in the browser box, the path is actually on your C drive, or wherever you installed it. Using this desktop organizer is the manual way of browsing through all the material in whichever proposal pack or contract pack or ProKit bundle you purchased. This is also the interface for Mac users. Using this desktop organizer, you can find samples, the pre-assembled documents, if you're not using the wizard software, and instruction manuals. Now we've clicked the wizard download link button. We'll wait for the wizard to complete downloading. When that's finished, we will click the run button, run the wizard software, and get that installed. Then we'll get the wizard set up. Now we're downloading and installing the wizard software. The wizard is a Word for Windows add-in, so it does require you to have Microsoft Word for Windows installed that can run macros. If you're using very old versions of Word, usually in the past it had to be the professional version of Word. Newer versions such as Office 365 will work in almost all of their versions. Now the wizard installer is going to open a Word document towards the end of the installation And it's very important that you follow the setup instructions to enable the macros. You will see multiple yellow bars across the top of the Word document. Marked as final is normal. You can ignore that. Do not click the Edit Anyway button. The signatures line is also normal. You do not have to deal with that one. The security warning has a button labeled Enable Content. Click that button to enable the Word macros. That is the only thing you have to do. Also, the Wizard installer will open a 5-minute quick start PDF document. This is an instruction manual that will walk you step by step through how to use the Wizard to create your first document. Follow this manual while you are running the Wizard to learn how to create your first document. Now that the Wizard is installed and the proposal pack is installed, we don't use the internet anymore. Everything is on your computer. You'll also see icons added to your Windows desktop. One is for the Wizard's 5-minute quick start PDF. The other one is how to run the Wizard, and the other one is for that manual browser-based interface. Now to run the Wizard, there's two ways. You can close this document and then just double-click this Run Proposal Pack Wizard icon, or click the Add-ins tab and then click the Run Wizard button. Now you've seen the setup screen, and from here you're ready to set up the Wizard and start following the instructions and in the tutorials to create your documents. See our other videos for additional ways on how to set up and use the Wizard software.